Well, Howard, let's take a look at exactly where that quake was, that 6.9. Now, first thing to notice is that it's on and over land. And in terms of tsunamis, even though it did generate a small tsunami, quakes on land don't usually generate large tsunamis. In fact, this one was well inshore and about a depth of 3 miles. Again, this happened at 12:32, but a lot of people felt it. In fact, I've been told people all the way to Kauai felt the jolt. We felt it here on Oahu. So this was definitely a significant quake. And these are just the quakes that are popping up within the last 3 hours. Look at the enormous amounts of quakes. Now, these are all of them, from magnitudes that are less than one all the way up to this magnitude 6.9. Now, I'm going to show you where the quakes have been popping up over the past 48 hours. There's three areas that we're seeing swarms. The first swarm that we saw was kind of near the Pu'u'o'o area, and that's the crater that actually emptied out and then, or filled up and then emptied out. So we have a swarm near Pu'u'o'o, and then we started getting more swarms near Kapoho Town. And this is the second area that we're seeing some smaller earthquakes. And then just today, we had another swarm by Halema'uma'u. This is the Halema'uma'u area. So we're seeing an extensive area, a lot of land being shaken by these quakes. And this extends all the way from Kilauea all the way to the eastern portions of the Big Island. And to show you where that lava is actually moving from, here's Pu'u'o'o crater, and this is a picture of it completely empty. Now, all of that lava went underground and eventually made its way up to Leilani Estate. So this was the risk area, this east rift zone, and you can see how it's moving towards the northwest and popped up near Leilani Estates, and where it pops up next, it could be anywhere within this area. Unfortunately, lava, unlike weather, is completely unpredictable. We could have more outbreaks, or we could have no outbreaks. It's just a wait-and-see situation with Mother Nature. Howard, back to you.